Foreplay is the special time where you build the sexual chemistry and tension between you and your partner. So, if you really want mind-blowing sex, focus on foreplay. I am not going to leave you hanging. Watch on for all the types of foreplay to use during sex. The types of foreplay you need to know. In the beginning, much of my understanding of sex came from advice, including the adult ones. I did not really know what sex was. Okay, of course, I knew what it was, but I did not really know. The movies do not really show you realistic sex, Hollywood or adult ones. But when you have sex, you realize it is much more complex than what movies and television shows. Many women complain about the lack of foreplay in bed, which is a huge factor in sex. In fact, foreplay can easily be argued as even better than penetration. This is the part where you are truly intimate with your partner when you touch, taste, smell, and hear them. Some people think it is a waste time, but, trust me, they are easy to remember. 1. It is all about the kiss. It always starts with a kiss, right? Though kissing does not always lead to sex, it can just be a hot and heavy makeout session, the kiss is very important. Starting foreplay off with kissing and caressing is extremely essential. Start off slowly, building up the makeout session kiss by kiss. Don't be shy to kiss their neck and breasts either. 2. Do not forget breasts. What a weird thing to say. You probably think, how can I forget the breasts? Well, you can and you will. During foreplay, it is easy to focus on one area of the body, but you need to expand. Do not forget the breasts. While you can kiss them, suck on them, lick them, whatever way stimulates your partner. The nipples contain sensitive nerve endings, so take advantage of that. 3. You do not have to be naked. Here's the thing about foreplay, it can start however you want it to, and whenever you want it to. You do not have to be in bed naked in order to engage in foreplay. If you are at work, you can send him or her a pic or naughty text, preparing them slowly for when you see them. That is the thing about foreplay, it can literally last for hours. 4. Undress your partner. You usually take off your own clothes, right? Would not it be hot if someone else took them off for you? See where I am going with this? Undressing your partner is one of the first steps in different types of foreplay, aside from kissing. You do not even have to kiss your partner while undressing them. Having your fingers gently graze theirs is highly arousing and stimulating. Maybe you will even get to witness them getting goosebumps. 5. Breathing. Who thought breathing could be a type of foreplay, but alas, it is. Use your breath to stimulate and arouse your partner. When you kiss them, move down their body, using your breath in sensitive areas such as their necks and genital area. Of course, make sure your breath smells nice, just saying. 6. The dry hump. I know, the dry hump does not have the best ring to it, but hear me out first. If you are in bed, on the couch or standing, you can grind up against your partner ever so slightly. You can be clothed or fully naked, but it not only shows how turned on you, but it also heats up the moment. 7. Get handsy. If you are kissing your partner with your hands limp, resting by your side, you are doing it all wrong. You have two hands for a reason, so you better start using them. During foreplay, use your hands. Touch their face, run your fingers through their hair, grab their breasts, thighs, ass, feel them. Do not be afraid to explore his or her body, unless they say no, and of course. 8. Over panty action. We usually assume that anything involving the vagina has to be done while naked. Now, I am totally with you on that, but you can have some vagina action with the panties on. Tease your partner by gently stroking and caressing around and on top of their vagina while they have underwear on. It, first of all, drives her insane, but also is highly arousing as well. 9. Oral. Now, if you do not like giving oral, that's completely okay. But if you are not against it, then you should incorporate oral sex into your foreplay routine. You do not need to be aggressive when you are down there. In fact, it is best to be a little gentle. While you want to tease the clitoris, lick it, suck it, and then leave it alone for a little bit. Do not spend all your time down there focused on the clitoris. 10. Labia love. Many people completely ignore the labia, but you should not. The labia is packed with nerve endings which needs some loving. You can hold each labia in between your thumb and forefinger, massaging it slowly, going up and down. 11. The ass. Now, this is not everyone's cup of tea, so this is not something you'd veto do. But if your partner is into it, then try it out. The anus has very sensitive nerve endings which are often ignored. If you are performing oral sex, you can lift their legs up slightly and gently lick around the anus. Or you can try it while your partner's in doggy style. Do not lick too aggressively, rather, just gently lick. 12. Relax. Listen, if you are nervous, none of these foreplay moves will feel that great for your partner. So, relax. It is just foreplay. Think about it like this: you learn about your partner and what they like through touch, taste, and sound. 13. Multitask. Use all these types of foreplay, and do not be afraid to multitask and do a couple of these moves at the same time. For example, finger your partner while eating their ass or make out with them while you touch their genitals. For more dating, relationship and marriage advice, please visit my blog hotamacarellashunshipwork.com. Also, subscribe to this YouTube channel and press the red button so that you can be notified whenever I release a new video.